We are at the end of our science week. I would say it's a science marathon, 5 days of very intensive discussions. I think we used a very good formula. The first day was really internal meetings among the programs that I've organized, and then we went to the heart of the event, the CRISP Science Forum, which I think went very well. We had many discussions. We had 160 people from all over the world thinking about progress, discussing the progress we have been making in terms of CRISP in the different themes: breeding, agronomy, mechanization, value chain work, pollution impact assessment, and also linking with development partners through our rice sector development hub concept. So I think that went really well. A lot of good results are coming out. And then the last 2 days, it was free time. Everybody was free to discuss, and I think many new ideas came up. And we had a special focus on a collaboration between Africa Rice and JIRCAS on agronomy work and breeding work. And I just came out of a meeting with CIRAD IRD and JIRCAS focusing on management of biotic stresses in rice in Africa. So
this was my first time in Benin and my first time to visit Africa Rice, and hence obviously my first time to participate in an event like this. So as a CRISP director, what I'm really looking for is that we get our products, our science right to ultimately deliver impact. So I first go back to what impact do we want to reach. And those are the major challenges, of course, that CRISP is addressing globally. We need to make sure that we produce enough food, rice in this case, that it's affordable to the poor, that it basically alleviates poverty, it contributes to health and nutrition. And we do this all to make sure that the environment that we produce in remains clean, so that our production systems are sustainable. These are global challenges and we need to respond to them. And since we are a CG center here in Africa Rice, we need to derive solutions that are based and grounded in science. So what I was looking for is, what is the science that Africa Rice and its partners is basically developing, is harnessing? What are the products, the solutions it's generating, and how does that, together with the partners, feed into ultimately having impact? And I should say I'm tremendously impressed by what I've heard. Like I say, it's my first exposure to Africa Rice, to West Africa. Tremendously impressed by the level of the science, the quality of the science, the enthusiasm by the staff. I was especially struck by how motivated people are. We had very long days, but everybody maintained a high level of enthusiasm, stayed until very late, even had evening meetings, and were back in the morning, and all basically towards that common objective of having impacts on these fields that I just mentioned. I'm also very impressed by the partnership. The way Africa Rice works is really different from the way that CIAT and IRI, not the way they work, but the way they are structured and rooted. Africa Rice belongs to its member states, to its shareholders, as your DG Papa Sek would say. And that really transpires throughout all the activities that are being undertaken. Grounded in partnership with a lot of attention to capacity building and making sure that what gets done to strengthen the capacity of the local partners. And I think what I've seen here is that what is happening here in Africa is geared towards having impact and lasting impact. So those are basically the impressions I want to share with you. I look forward to traveling a lot in Africa the coming year and actually seeing this work in practice. Because frankly, these last 5 days, I've only seen meeting rooms and I've seen slides of what's happening in the field. And now I want to go out and see what's happening in the field.